Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV. I'm Mark Wallace and I'm joined by LaCie. She's been in several videos in the past. Well, today's video is about culling images in Lightroom. And so LaCie and I spent about an hour or so shooting a bunch of different sets. We also had another model named Monique that came in a little bit earlier. I shot her. And so now on my laptop, I've got all these images that we shot, and I need to sort through those, pick the winners, and then make sure I process everything and get them back to the models so they can put them in their portfolios. So how do you do that quickly? How do you get from camera to the computer to your client in a very efficient and fast way? Well, there's some really cool shortcuts in Lightroom, so let's hop over there and I'll show you that right now. One of the best ways to quickly move through Lightroom and select the images that are the winners are by using keyboard shortcuts. Now, we can't go through every single keyboard shortcut that we're gonna be using in this tutorial, but I will show you one that rules them all. That is Command or Control forward slash. When you do that, you'll bring up this window that shows you all of the library shortcuts. Now, we're gonna be using a lot of the view shortcuts that are listed on the left here, the rating shortcuts for setting ratings and picking images, and the flagging shortcuts. So if you don't know what these are, again, all you have to do is hit Command or Control forward slash in Lightroom, and that's gonna bring up this keyboard shortcut cheat sheet. That works, by the way, in every module, the Develop, Map, Book, Slideshow, Print, and Web module all allow you to do that. Just hit Command or Control forward slash, and those shortcuts will be showing up on your screen. Okay, now what we're gonna be doing here is there are two modes that we'll be using in this tutorial. That is the Compare mode and the Survey mode. You can find those in the Library module at the very bottom of your screen in the toolbar. If your toolbar isn't there, make sure you hit T to bring that up. You'll see that there is this little XY, that's the Compare view, and then next to that is the Survey view or Survey mode, and you'll use that to supplement your flagging and rating system to pick winners for images that are very similar. So when I shot Monique and I shot Marilee, we intentionally shot a lot of images that were very, very similar to illustrate how to use these views to choose the winner, the best of very similar images. Now, to make this really make sense, we're gonna zip over here. I have created some numbers and animal names here for us to compare and rate and figure out which ones are the best. This is gonna help us understand these modes a little bit better. We're going to start by using the compare mode. So I'm gonna click on number one, and then I'm going to hit the C button, our C key. That's gonna bring me into the compare mode, and you'll get a view like this. And to make this a little bit easier to understand, I'm gonna open up my film strip so you can see all these different images here. What we're doing here is we're comparing two items. On the left is our select, that's the winner, that's the king, that's the best, that's the one that we think is the select image to show to our client. On the right is the candidate. That's the image we're saying, is this one better than the one that we've selected? So is the candidate better than the select? So right now we're saying, is number two better than number one? Now we can move through these candidates by either using our right and left arrows right here, or we can just use the right and left arrow keys on the keyboard, and you'll see here in the film strip that I'm moving back and forth between all these different things. So I'm saying, is number two better than one? No. Is number three better than one? No. Is number four better than one? No. How about five? How about six? How about seven? So eventually I'm gonna find an image that's better than the select. Once that happens, what we need to do is we need to make our candidate the select. And we do that by clicking on this little button right over here. So it says make select. When we click that, now we're saying number seven is the king, it's the winner, it's the best. That's what we want our client to see. Seven is the select. Now we're looking to say, is eight better than seven? No. How about nine? No. How about 10? No. All right, seven is the winner. We've compared it to everything by process of elimination. It's the winner. So what we can do then on number seven is we can then hit P, and we can hit five or whatever. We can set our rating, we can set colors, and we can make that our winner. Now let's go in and look at something a little bit different here. Let's go and say that we are looking at animals. We're trying to figure out which animal is our favorite. So it's very, very simple. Are horses better than birds? Well, no, I think birds are better. How about kittens? Well, yeah, kittens are better than that. So what about puppies or kittens? Now this is where it gets difficult, because we know that snakes and zebras, those aren't as good, but kittens and puppies, well, these two things, well, they're very, very similar. So what can we do? Well, Lucky for us, we can choose both of them. So I'm going to click on the select, hit P, click on the candidate, hit P. But then I'm going to have to make a choice. Which one is better, the best, the very, very best? I'm going to say puppies is the very best. So I'm going to make that the select. And then I might rate that as a 5-star animal when I go back to my grid view. Now look, we have all of our ratings. I can say, show me everything that I flagged. And then we know that number 7 and puppies, those are our 5-star ratings. And we've chosen the two things that are the best of the best of these animals and numbers. Okay, now how does that relate to real life? And how can we use all of this? Well, there's one other thing I need to show you before we move on, and that is stacking. Stacking allows us to group similar items into stacks. Think of them like cards, a deck of cards. It's stacked up and you can expand or collapse those. So it's easy to do this. So I'm going to take the animals here. I'm going to click on birds and then I'm going to shift click on zebras. Now notice I've selected all of these animals. And then what I'm going to do is right click, go to stacking, group into stack. I'll click on that. And now we have this group of images. Now on the right, there's these two little lines. On the left, there's two little lines. If you click that, it expands that stack. If you click it again, it collapses that. Or you can just hit the S key to expand, S again to collapse. I'm going to do that same thing with our numbers here. But instead of right-clicking, going to stacking, and saying group into stack, what I'm going to do instead is just hit Command or Control G. And that will stack that. And so now we have two groups, numbers and animals. We can go through there and we can use those. Now here's one caveat, one thing you have to understand. Notice we have these two flags inside this stack. If I collapse the stack, go up here to attribute, say show me everything that is flagged. Notice no photos match the filter. Why not? We know we have two images that are flagged. The reason for that is these will only show things that are in expanded stacks. So I'm going to expand this stack, go up here to attribute, show me everything that's flagged, and there we go. Kittens and puppies show up. It works just fine. How does this really relate to real life? Well, lucky for you, we have a shoot that we did. So I'm going to go down here. I created a collection here, and it's called Sorting the Winners. Now notice in this collection, we have a bunch of similar items. So the first thing I want to do is stack these in items that are similar so that I can sort through these and sort of do these by groups. It's really easy to do this and we don't have to do this manually. In other words, we don't have to go through here and shift click and do all the stuff that we did with the animals and numbers. There's a better way to do it if you've done a photo shoot. So in this photo shoot, I shot for a little while, took a break, reset, maybe we changed an outfit, started shooting again, took a break, changed outfit, started shooting again. So there are gaps between these photo shoots, these different sets in time. And so we can just use that to our advantage. So we're going to right click, go to stacking, auto stack by capture time. Now when I click on that, I can say how much time is between each stack. In other words, how long is the break between this first shot of Monique here on this background and this second set? And so I know by playing around with this little slider here that we took about 2 minutes between, 2 or more minutes between each different lighting setup. And so I'm going to set this at 2 minutes. You can play with that and you can see how many stacks you're going to get a live preview here by just moving this around. So I know that we only had 6 different groups. And so I'm just going to go over here to 2 minutes. And once I have that, it says, okay, 6 stacks. So I'm going to say stack. So I'm going to right click on this, say stacking. And then I'm going to say collapse all stacks. Now look at this. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can hit the S key to expand these. There's the blue dress. There's the red dress. There's the little set that we did that I didn't like. Here is Marley on the bench, etc. So we've automatically grouped these into stacks that make sense. That's really going to help us, especially when we go to a client. Maybe you shot a catalog or something and you want to say, okay, here's the red dress, the blue dress, or a wedding. Here's the reception. Here's the signing of the wedding contract. Here are all those different things. We can show those in groups. It really makes sense. Now we can dive in here, expand these, and start taking a look using those tools that we have. The first thing I noticed is we have 2 really dark images and we have a bunch of light images. Why is that? So I'm going to click on this first dark image here and the second one, hit C to compare. And the nice thing is I can click and zoom to 100%. And look at that. What is the difference? And I remember, oh yeah, in this image here, I was using a studio light. It's crystal clear. Over here, I was using ambient light and we gave up on it because we just didn't have enough light. So this first light right here, yeah, that's a winner. I'm gonna hit P, I'm gonna pick that. I'm gonna go out here. And so I've already used compare in a different way than I showed you before to figure out which item is the winner. All right, let's go down here to a different stack. Let's go down here to this blue dress. These are all very, very similar images. Now, one of the things I haven't shown you yet is the survey mode. So survey mode is the one that's next to compare. You get into that by hitting N. Now, this is by process of elimination. Instead of comparing one image to the next, to the next, to the next, this shows you everything in sort of a light table view. And what you can do, there's a little black X next to each of these images. If you click on that, it just removes them from the view. It doesn't change any of the metadata. It doesn't change the flag. It doesn't change the rating. It doesn't do anything but just take it away. So this right here, well, Marley has closed eyes. I'm going to get rid of that. I don't like this pose. And so we're going to start being really, really picky. And by process of elimination, we're saying, no, don't like that one. Of these three here, I think this one's a little bit wonky. Okay, these look very similar. Get rid of that. These two look almost the same. Now we've got two images. I don't like this one as much as this one. That's the winner. P for pick. I hit 4 stars. Go back to my grid view, and I've already picked the winner. And so that's what survey mode does for you. It allows you to really quickly look at your images. So again, you can go through here. You can say, oh, you know what? These are very, very similar in survey mode. She's looking weird there. This is not so good. I don't like the way this dress looks, etc. And you can just really quickly remove images from your selection until finally you go, you know what? That's the best one right there. Boom. And then you have it. Survey mode, compare mode, flagging, picking, rating. It will really help you, especially using your shortcut keys to select the winners, specifically winners that are very similar images in a set. Pick the best one of the best, and then you can go in and say, you know what, show me all the ones that I've flagged as winners. You can take those, and then you can take them to your client, show them off. They'll choose the ones that they like the best, and then everybody wins because you've saved yourself a lot of time. Well, that's all there is to it. Once you know the shortcut keys and those tricks to culling images, you can really blast through those really quickly, do all of your edits and get them to your clients like Marley here, and they're happy, you're happy, you've saved yourself time, and it's really, really easy. Thank you again for being a wonderful model in this episode. Thank you for joining us for this episode. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV, it's free. And also check out the Adorama Learning Center because we have a lot of content that really fills in the gaps of the things that we can't include in every single video. So check it out. It's free. So why not do that? Thanks again for joining us. I'll see you again next time.